you can always avoid this mistake, which is so common that 1 in 4 vulnerabilities uncovered by the GitHub Security Lab are injection flaws. Injection attacks are characterized by the ability to change the normal flow of a program. In some cases, attackers can even execute arbitrary code with elevated privileges to perform anything they like read, modify, or delete data, something that they will normally not have enough permissions to achieve directly. But how is it caused? The short answer is that it's caused from user input that is either not neutralized at all or neutralized incorrectly. The root cause of this vulnerability, however, is deeper. When we code, we often make assumptions of what the user input will be, but in reality, it can be literally anything. We tend to trust the user and assume good intentions, which is consistently proven not to be the case. What leads to injection problems is exactly that lack of verifying these assumptions for user control input, leading to the classic injection attacks like SQL injection and cross-site scripting. The code on screen is actually real-world code, vulnerable to a variant of injection attacks called command injection. This advisory was recently published by our researcher Alvaro Muñoz, or Pontester, who uncovered this flaw in Apache Storm. Alvaro achieved remote code execution through the user-supplied value username that was concatenated to a shell command without first being neutralized. This brings us to mitigations, which start from assuming that all input is malicious. A good validation strategy is to accept only what is known to be safe and reject all the rest, also known as only accepting allow lists. Allow lists are a much safer strategy than block lists, and this is because the latter can leave enough room for attackers to eventually bypass. Further defensive techniques include transformation of the input into something safe. Such techniques include encoding and escaping. That was it for today, folks. If you've learned something new today, tell us about it in comments, and also tell us which vulnerabilities you struggle with so we can cover those in future sessions. In the meantime, stay updated with us by following our Twitter, where we publish our latest advisories and future conference talks. Remember, quality code is secure code.